गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन टू क्लास 7 ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज अवर चेंजिंग अर्थ. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी पार्ट 2. बिफोर गोइंग टू पार्ट 2, लेट अस सी व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड इन पार्ट 1. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी स्टडीड अबाउट लिथोस्फियरिक प्लेट्स, देन इवोल्यूशन ऑफ लैंड फॉर्म्स, देन वॉल्केनो, व्हाट इज वॉल्केनो, दैट इज इट्स डेफिनेशन, देन द अर्थक्वेक as well as the earth moments, endogenic as well as exogenic moments. And let us see in part 2 what we are going to study. First of all, we are going to study the work of a river. The work of a river, where it comes, the exogenic forces. We are going to see the exogenic forces. Already we have seen the endogenic forces, earthquake, volcano and landslides, and under the exogenic forces, that the work of a river we are going to see. Now, the running water in the river erodes the landscape. Yes, we know very well the running water, well, if the speed is more, then it erodes the landscape as well. When the river tumbles at a steep angle, so tumbles means when jumps, tumble hota hai, girta hai, okay, at a steep angle over very hard rocks. Kahan girta hai? Over very hard rock par girta hai. Kahan se girta hai? From a great height to a hard rock, or down a steep valley inside, it forms a waterfall. So when the waterfall forms, when a river tumbles at a steep angle over very hard rock or down, नीचे गिरता है जब in a steep valley. Steep valley मतलब बहुत कंदक करके बोलते हैं इसको हिंदी में. And it forms a waterfall. You can see just is a picture, image of waterfall, and it is probably, it might be there in your textbook also. So it forms from a great height to the down, then it forms the waterfall. And using this waterfall only, electricity is generated. The speed, using the speed. Now let's move. The work of a river, it continues, okay. Now, as the river enters the plains, it twists and turns, forming large bend called meanders. So, what is meander? Now the river from the mountain, it has now fallen down, either on a rocky or surface or on a steep valley. If it is steep valley, then it is a waterfall. So, however, from the mountain, now the water is slowly entered the plain. And as it enters the plain, it forms large bend, and that is called meander. Now, you can see in the picture also, in the image also, large bend. You can see the large bend, twist and turn. You can see the green background. Green background is an indication of plain. Okay, and it takes so many curves. Due to continuous erosion and deposition along the sides of the meander, it is also called as meander, the ends of the loop comes closer and closer. Now, there is a question, you might ask a question, madam, what is loop? Loop means is a shape produced by curve that bends round across itself. That bends round across. Just अगर हम मैं simple भाषा में अगर मैं बोलूँ, 8 को अगर sleeping line में लिखे तो कैसे लगता है? 8, number 8, E-I-G-H-T को sleeping line में imagine करके लिखो, कैसे दिखता है? It forms a large curve and it turns and it twists, okay, round and crosses itself. उसी को cross करता है. And that is called the loop. Okay, let's continue. Due to continuous erosion and deposition along the sides of the meander or meander, the ends of the loop comes closer and closer. Let's see a picture, okay. Now this is one. The river has already entered the plain and it takes huge curves, isn't it? And It's a big curve. You can see that yellow portion, that yellow one is now it that is the neck. Now the neck is about to fill. यहाँ से भी deposition हो रहे हैं sediments और यहाँ से भी sediment deposition होगा और ऐसे ही अगर थोड़े time तक चलते रहेगा तो ये क्या होगा, cut होगा, उसमें से cut off होगा. Okay, now I'll come to that point after. Then in due course of time मतलब बहुत time, after a long time you can say, or in between you can say, the meander loop cuts off from the river. Kyun cuts off from the river? Because the sediments are brought from both the ends and because of that main river se cut off hota hai wo. And forms a cut off lake, or it is also called as Oxbow Lake. Here in the picture also you can see that वो चंद्रमा और चांद जैसा और मून जैसा shape है, that is Oxbow Lake. And here also you can see that, so this is the, or you can say the way of path of river. And in due course of time ये जो बड़ा curve है, ये येलो लाइन, एज आई टोल्ड यू, इट को बोथ द एंड्स दैट कम क्लोजर एंड जे इट कट ऑफ फ्रॉम द मेन रिवर एंड फॉर्म्स एन ऑक्स बाव लेक. देन दिस इज द पिक्चर ऑफ ऑक्स बाव लेक. सी इट एंटर्स द प्लेन, इट टेक्स ह्यूज लार्ज बेंड्स एंड ऑल, एंड इन ड्यू कोर्स ऑफ टाइम ड्यू टू द सेडिमेंट दैट लार्ज बेंड और आई कैन से इट कट्स ऑफ फ्रॉम द मेन रिवर एंड फॉर्म्स ऑक्स बाव लेक. नाउ एट टाइम्स द रिवर ओवरफ्लो द बैंक्स. वट इज बैंक? नदी किनारा. एंड एट टाइम्स समटाइम्स द इफ देर इज हैवी रेनफॉल ऑफकोर्स इट ओवरफ्लो द बैंक. तो हम भी देखते हैं ना, बहुत 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 ज़्यादा बारिश आता है तो नर्मदा किनारे जाके देखते हैं कि कितना जोर से पानी कैसे बह रहा है. एंड इट एंटर्स टू द नियर बाई फील्ड्स. This leads to flooding of the nearby neighboring area. ज़्यादा होता है तो बस किनारे से बाहर आता है and enters to the agriculture land और field और घर और building और रास्ते, सब जगह पे पानी आ जाता है. As it floods, it deposits layers of fine soil and other material called sediments along the banks. So when it flood, it deposits a fine layer or fine soil. बहुत अरे कैन से यू कैन से फाइन वाला होता है फाइन सॉइल एंड अदर मटीरियल कॉल्ड सेडिमेंट्स दैट इज़ वेरी फर्टाइल यू कैन से. दिस लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फ्लड प्लेन. कैन यू सी इन द पिक्चर फ्लड प्लेन? सो द प्लेन फॉर्म्ड बाय यू कैन सी दैट ग्रे कलर. सो इन बिटवीन दैट ग्रे कलर वाटर है और उसके बाद किनारे छोड़ के यहाँ तक आने के वजह से एंड इन बिटवीन यू कैन सी दैट ग्रे कलर पोर्शन एंड दैट इज द फ्लड प्लेन और द प्लेन फॉर्म्ड ड्यू टू फ्लड इज कॉल्ड फ्लड प्लेन. दिस लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फ्लड प्लेन. द रेस्ड बैंक. वट इज नाउ रेस्ड? रेस्ड मतलब जो रेस, रेस मतलब क्या, अप, अप हो गया. अभी द रेस्ड बैंक्स आर कॉल्ड द लेवीज. लेवीज मीन्स वॉट? द रेस्ड बैंक्स. अभी किनारा क्या है उसका थोड़ा बढ़ गया है, थोड़ा उसका रेज हो गया, अप हो गया एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड लेवीज. एज द रिवर अप्रोचेस द सी ऑफकोर्स फ्रॉम द माउंटेन थ्रू द प्लेन इट विल अल्टीमेटली गो एंड रीच द सी ओनली. The speed of the flowing water decreases slowly, slowly. The speed of the flowing water decreases and the river break up into streams. What is a stream? Stream is a narrow river. Now it is about to join the sea and before that its flow decreases. And it forms a number of streams called distributors. You might have seen the river Ganga and its distributors. So, if not, you will be going to learn in the higher classes the distributors of river Ganga, the distributors of river Yamuna, like that. Now, what is delta? Have you heard delta? Yes, you have marked also last time delta, Sundarban Delta. Am I right? Yes. The river becomes so slow that it begins to deposit its load. Whatever the sediments it has, all it start to deposit at wherever it is. Each distributary forms its own mouth. I said, what is distributary? Or I can say the stream, a narrow river. So before the river joins the main sea, it takes a number of turns into, or it breaks into a number of small river, or narrow river called the streams. And each stream, it is also called as distributor, and each stream forms its own mouth. Matlab uska jo river ko join hone ka uska jo rasta, ek ek rasta. The collection of sediments from all the mouth forms delta. You can see in the picture also, so many door mein aapko river sea dikhai deta hai, but wo sea ko ek hi rasta nahi hai, ek jagah se jata hai, and one course forms takes another path in like that, and all together they form sediments, they together form the delta. This is what the work of a river. So this is one of the exogenic forces. Now let us see the work of a sea waves. The erosion and deposition of sea waves give rise to coastal landforms. Landforms formed at the coastal area. They are called coastal landform. How it is formed? Due to erosion as well as of deposition. Sea waves continuously strike the rocks. Rocks jo hota hai, isko continuously hit karta rehta hai waves. Iske badle mein kya hota hai? Rocks mein kya develop? Cracks develop in the rocks. Over the time, they become larger and larger. Which one is becoming larger and larger? That crack. Hamare teeth mein bhi aise hota hai. Agar zara sa crack hota hai, so immediately if we doesn't consult the dentist, then that crack develop. And over the time or in due course of time, to hame kya karna padta hai? Hame to wo teeth ko hi remove karna padta hai. And it becomes cavity over there. Space ho jata hai wahan par. Okay, so kadda jaise ho jata hai. That is what, over the time it becomes larger and larger crack. Thus hollow like caves are formed. Hollow means hole like caves are formed on the rocks. Why? Because of the continuous strike of the sea waves. They are called sea caves. As these cavities become bigger and bigger, cavity hai, dent mein, tooth mein cavity hota hai. Agar immediately fill nahi kiya hota hai, to cavity badhta hai. Bigger and bigger, only the roof of the cave is remain forming sea arcs. Now we will going to see this, what is sea caves as well as sea arcs. Okay, let me see. So the first image, this is a rock, and because of the sea waves, it continuously hits the crack. First of all, simple crack develops, then it becomes a cave, then it takes the picture of arc, then stalk, then stump, last one. Okay, we have already seen what is crack, we have already studied what is cave. Now we are going to study the arc. Now sea arcs. Okay, these cavities become bigger and bigger. Is bogger likha hai, bigger. Only the roof of the cave is remain forming sea arcs. These wall-like features are called stacks. We have seen this is stalk, wall-like features. Now the cave ka upar ka portion bhi kya ho gaya? Niche se erosion hote hote hote, ye third wala figure wala ka upar ka hissa bhi nikal gaya. Now only upar ka hissa nikal gaya, full big, upar bhi kuch nahi, and stalk form ho jata hai, and form stalk. The steep rocky coast rising almost vertically above the sea water is called sea cliff. So the sea waves deposit sediments along the shores forming beaches. Now the steep rocky coast raising almost vertically, that is above the sea water is called sea cliff. Here they have not mentioned about sea cliff, and okay, it is standing for vertical, only vertical portion is remaining. And last one, stump, they have not mentioned about. Before that, let me come to the point. The sea waves deposit sediments along the shores, forming beaches. That is why we are able to see the most beautiful, or I can say, beaches of the world, as well as in India. Mumbai Beach, Juhu Beach is very famous. Somnath mein hum dekh sakte in Gujarat, isn't it? And Dumas in Surat. So as I told you, the features made by the sea caves. And this is the glimpse, or you can see the rocks, real picture. You can see, first of all, the crack develop. Crack is leading to the cavity, or cavity is leading to the sea caves. And over the time, hit hote hote upar ka portion bhi nikal jayega. So okay, this is what, this much picture. And in due course of time, upar ka portion bhi nikal sakta hai. Now, the I hope this is what we are going to see. Right, that's what we are going to study. Now, the work of eyes, again, it is also, as I told you, it's the exogenic forces. Now, glaciers are where we can find glaciers? In the mountains. Okay, glaciers are rivers of ice which too erode the landscape by bulldozing soil. Have you heard the word bulldozer? Where we are using the bulldozer? Bulldozer hum kahan use karte? Agar hame kisi building ko girana hai ya mitti ko zameen se khodna hai, then at that time we are using that bulldozer. So it bulldozing the soil and stones to expose the solid rock below. Glaciers carve out deep hollows there. So glaciers also carve deep hollow where? In the mountains. As the ice melt, they get filled up with water and becomes beautiful lakes in the mountains. When? In which season? Can you say? It is possible only in the summer season. In the winter, you cannot find any type of this glacier or lakes. So, because in the winter season, that again that water, it may, or I can say, the ice may cover that lake. And when the ice melts in the summer season, it forms a beautiful lake. The material carried away by the glacier, such as rocks, big and small. What are the materials carried away by the glacier? They are the big and small rocks. Then sand, then silt, they all get deposited, and these deposits form glacier moraines. What is glacier moraine? The material carried away by glacier, it may be sand, it may be rock, it may be silt, they are all called as the glacier moraines. Now you can see the glacier, the work of ice. So it when in the summer the water melts. Now the work of wind, an active wave of erosion and deposition in the desert is wind. So we are now talking about desert, and wind also one of the exogenic agent. In the deserts we can see the rocks in the shape of a mushroom, commonly called mushroom rocks. Have you seen any mushroom rocks? No, if not, you will be going to see in picture. Winds erode the lower section of the rock more than the upper part. Let's see that. So in the middle one picture, see, I'm talking about the winds that erodes the lower part more than the upper part, one by one. And therefore such rocks have narrow base and wider top. Let's see, narrow base is very small, and the top is, or I can say, much wider. Next point, when the wind blows, it lifts and transports sand from one place to another. Yes, we can see that we are eating kurkure, we are fond of eating that this kurkure or lays and all. isn't it? And immediately the wind is with full of velocity, it can carry that empty, you can say plastic, and it may carry from the place where you are eating, and it may drop into the place where, or I can say, as soon as the velocity or the speed of the wind decreases, definitely it will fall over there. So when the wind blows, it lift karta hai and transports sand from one place to another. Now I'm not talking about plastic, I'm talking about sand, because that wind is working as the agent of erosion. When it stops blowing, the sand falls and get deposits in low hill like structure, deposited in low hill like structure called sand dunes. Now what is a sand dune? So when the wind stops blowing, the sand falls. अरे अभी हवा में है, अभी सडन हवा रुक गए तो क्या हो गया, ऊपर से धड़ार करके गिर गया. क्या गिर गया? आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट सैंड. एंड ऐसी सैंड गिरते गिरते लो हिल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इज फॉर्म्ड, एंड दैट स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉल्ड एज सैंड ड्यून्स. Now we'll see the different pictures. See, there are three variety of pictures. They are all formed by the wind. When the grains of sand are very light and fine, the wind can carry it over long distances. Yes, lightweight hai to bahut dur tak le ja sakte hain. When such sand is deposited in large areas, it called as loess. So what is loess? Loess is that the sand is deposited, that is also lightweight sand, they are deposited at large area, they are called as loess. So this is what about the chapter number 2, that is our changing earth. Already studied endogenic forces in part 1, and today we are studying about the exogenic forces, wherein we have studied the work of a river, the work of wind, the work of sea waves, as well as the glaciers. So I have covered almost all the topics from your textbook. So okay, then I'll also attach a video related to this topic. Stay tuned. Thank you.
Meanders. The course of a river comprises of three distinct parts. First is the upper or the mountain course, where the river originates. Here, the velocity of the water is faster due to the steep gradient. The floor of the valley is narrow and the valleys are V-shaped. Second is the middle or the valley course, where floors are wider and the sides of the valley are more gently sloping. Here, the velocity of the river is slower than the upper stage. Meanders are typical landforms found in this stage of the river. The third part of the river is the lower course, which has a gentle slope and is almost flat. The river channel is usually at its widest and deepest here, because the amount of water flowing within the river is at its greatest. Oxbow lakes are conspicuous features in the lower course of a river, apart from the deltas where the river drains into seas. Now we will discuss about what are meanders and how are they formed. Meanders are formed in the middle course of a river. The rivers flow through almost a flat plain in the middle courses. As water flowing under gravity seldom flows straight for any long distance, a winding course soon develops. The irregularities of the ground force the river to swing in great S-shaped curves, forming horseshoe-like loops called meanders. Now let us see how a meander forms. The water in a river channel flows faster round the outside bend of a river due to centrifugal force, whereas it is relatively slow on the inside bends. the fast-flowing water on the outside bend erodes the river bank, whereas slow-moving water deposits sand and mud on the inside bend. At the site of erosion on the outside bend, a steep river cliff is created. The water piles up on the outside bend due to centrifugal force. A bottom current is set up in a corkscrew motion which deposits the eroded material on the inner bank, forming a slip-off slope. In the lower course of a river, a meander becomes very much pronounced. The outside bend gets eroded rapidly and the meander loop becomes almost a complete circle. Gradually, the narrow necks of the loop erode further and intersect each other. Now, the river cuts through the intersection to flow in a straight path. As a result, the meander loop is abandoned and it forms an oxbow lake. The oxbow lake later turns into a swamp and subsequent floods may silt up the lake. It becomes marshy and eventually dries up.
Brought to you by Compeat India's Jito Bharat, a one-stop internet-based interactive coaching for civil services exams. For more information, log on to www.jitobharat.com.